How much truth could actually come out of the Mortis Theory? Well, first, if you haven't already, go check out my first video explaining the Mortis Theory. I'll have it linked in the comments and up above. But basically, the theory is about how Ezra, Kanan, and Ahsoka will become Force gods, replacing the son, father, and daughter in the Clone Wars arc that took place on the Force planet Mortis. So in this video, I'll be looking for evidence against the Mortis Theory with help from some theory crafting community members. The first of our community members' thoughts comes from Rolling Thunder 987, and he suggests that it would be cool, but Ezra does not work as the sun. They could have gone that way, but bottled it in season 3. Maul was the only character who would have worked as the sun. There is no other we have seen. I love this idea that Maul could have actually been the sun. Nice theory crafting, Rolling Thunder. And moving on here, Jennifer Cook agrees with the idea that Ezra could not replace the sun. She states, "It's a weird theory, but I can't argue against it on those grounds because Dave Filoni promised weird for the second half of the season. My main objection would be, does Ezra qualify as an avatar of the dark? And that is the thing that doesn't sit right with me. Just because someone has gone to a dark place doesn't mean they have the potential to embody the darkness. Now, if they were to go that route, they'd need to show why the dark side is necessary and why it would be heroic for Ezra to take the aspect upon him. If they went at it from that angle, it could be very interesting. Personally, I love your idea, Jennifer, that they could show the darkness is necessary and make this sort of a heroic action for Ezra. But I'm not sure if they have time for this with so few episodes remaining. So I think I side more with your point that Ezra is going to a dark place, but will come back to the light. Similar to Luke in the throne room in Return of the Jedi. He goes to a dark place, almost killing his father, but is able to bring it back in the end. But moving on here, we have perhaps the most definitive evidence against the theory coming from Kimmy Skywalker. She suggests there's no reason for a new daughter, father, and son. When all three died, balance was brought to Mortis. The reason we see the ones in Rebels is because they are letting us know that they were a real family. Most suspected they were a metaphor, that Anakin, Obi-Wan, and Ahsoka were just shown a vision. Now we know they're real. Filoni alludes to this when asked about the ones. He says they were part of the galaxy's folklore. They must have been around since the ancient Jedi. The balance of the Force is going to be brought by Ben and Rey. The ones are no longer needed, but their story and symbolism is important. Great ideas there, Kimmy. I really like the idea that Anakin was the one that brought balance to Mortis. It echoes what happens in Return of the Jedi when he kills off the Sith, bringing balance to the Force there as well. But let's move on. We got one more comment here from Jack Fletcher 4, I believe it is. He makes an interesting point, commenting that I've always thought that when Ahsoka, Obi-Wan, and Anakin died, they would replace the Force wielders on Mortis. When they all died, Ahsoka would become the daughter, Anakin the son, Kenobi the father. It just seems more fitting to me than Ezra and Kanan fitting in the roles. Yeah, that seems really interesting. I mean, those three were the ones that visited Mortis, so it'd make a lot of sense if they were the ones to assume that role in the future. Thanks a lot for sharing that with us, Jack, and awesome theory crafting as always, man. But hey, Star Wars fans, I'm Mike, and you've been watching Force Within TV, where your theories matter. So before you go, please consider sharing your thoughts and theories on the question of the day. What you share might just end up in one of my community videos just like this one. And today the question is about episode 10. What do you think is going to happen in episode 10, Jedi Knight? Let me know in the comments below. And remember, my fellow theory crafting Jedi, use the Force within you to make the Star Wars community a better place. Share your theories and encourage those to do the same. And may the Force be with you.